There we go.
Too good to get out. You got too good to get out. Keep
they gonna make
break that split up.
Can you call us and see if we wait for her or how long she's on? She's the only one that's not here. Well, I go.
Okay.
And just let Jonathan, you out here? Miss Janice, just let Jonathan. Jonathan is the director. Just let him know, okay?
Okay.
Thank you.
is the strength of my life, of whom shall I be afraid? Why cast down, O my soul? And why are you disquieted within me? Hope in God, for I shall yet praise him, the help of my countenance and my God. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in the time of trouble. Therefore we will not fear, even though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea. He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The everlasting God, the Lord, the Creator of the ends of the earth, neither faints nor is weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the weak, and to those who have no might, he increases strength. But those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. And lo, I'm with you always, even until the end of the world. Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he may live, though he may die, yet he shall live. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you that I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, that you may be also. And where I go, you know, and that the way you know. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you're going, and how can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except by me. Amen.
Amen.
We've come to the homegoing celebration of our dear beloved Perry Bettinger, father, grandfather, great-grandfather, great-grandfather, deacon, a servant, man of God, who had a heart after God's own heart. We just thank God for his life and his legacy. And we thank God for allowing him to have 101 years. A man with a beautiful smile and a beautiful heart. A man who had a relationship with the Lord and who loved his family. We'll have scripture and prayer, and then we'll have any acknowledgments. And then we'll read the obituary salvo. Scripture reading will be coming from Romans 8, 38 through 39. Romans 8, 38 through 39. And the word of the Lord says, for I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Let us pray. Our Father and our God, we come thank you now, God, for the life and the legacy of Perry Bettinger. God, we know that you're God and God all by yourself. God, you sit high, but you never forget to look down low. God, you're so awesome and worthy to be praised. God, we just thank you for giving us another day, a day we've never seen before and a day we'll never see again. But in this day, Lord, we have some hearts that are heavy. In this day, Lord, we have a family that needs to be comforted. In this day, Lord, we have some that need your strength, Lord. God, give us your power. God, give us your joy. The word says the joy of the Lord is our strength. The word says weeping may endure for a night, but joy comes in the morning. God, we thank you for allowing us to have him on this side for 101 years, God. God, you allowed him to see so many things since 1918. God, he went from dirt roads to gravel roads to rock roads to concrete roads to asphalt roads. God, from no TV to color TV. God, we thank you, God. But now, God, you've called him home to the other side so that where you are, he may be also. Thank you, God, for this family, God. Thank you for his sons and daughters. Keep them like only you can. God, keep this entire family like only you can. God, help them to hold on to God, to your unchanging hands. Help us to hold on to the hope, knowing that we'll see him again on the other side. Because when we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we get to see Grandma and Grandpa Bettinger again, we can sing and shout the victory. God, we thank you for allowing both of them to be married for so many years. And God, we know that they're united now with you. God, we love you, we adore you, we can't do nothing without you. So continue to go with us and stand by us. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. And do we have any acknowledgments from family? Then I have two to read, one from Meadowline Baptist Church and one from Cane Run Missionary Baptist Church. Meadowline Baptist Church, April 17, 2020. One heart of gold stopped beating, two shiny eyes at rest. God broke our hearts to prove to us he only takes the best. To some, he'll be forgotten, and others just a part of the past. But to us who loved and lost you, his memory will always last. To the family and friends of Deacon Perry Bettinger and our members, the Miller and Settles family, we, the pastor, officers, members, and friends of the Meadowline Baptist Church of Valley Station, Kentucky, extend to you our heartfelt sympathy in your time of sorrow. We pray that you hold on to God's unchanging hands. If you lean and depend on the Lord, he will see you through. Deacon Bettinger was a beam of sunshine to so many people in so many ways. He has an unforgettable smile and a beautiful spirit. Most of us from Meadowline and the Valley Station area remember him for their beautiful garden. They were always sharing their crops and blessings to the community. Sister Bettinger, right by his side, smiling and just so happy together. He, they were always dressed to the nines, and he was one of the only men I saw outside of Hollywood and TV who had a fedora hat for every occasion. From the field to the church, he had one on. Oh, how we love to hear his stories, but more importantly, he knew the Bible and loved the Lord first. We will surely honor his legacy. Matthew 5 and 4 says, blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. We know that words cannot take away the sadness that you feel. But please know that we care and you are in our thoughts and prayers. May God's love be your strength. Here, and we're here for you in this difficult time. Done by the order of the church, Sister Jackie Barnett, Church Clerk, Secretary, First Lady Ramonda, and William A. Hodge, Senior Pastor. That's from the Meadowlawn Baptist Church. Cane Run Missionary Baptist Church. Because he loves me, says the Lord, I will rescue him. I will protect him, for he acknowledges my name. He will call on me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvations. Psalm 91, 14 through 16. Whereas today, the members of Cane Run Missionary Baptist Church and the family and friends of Deacon Perry Bedger come together on one accord to say farewell to a great man of God. Whereas we are not saddened by his death, but we rejoice for him because our dear brother told us for over 40 years that heaven is the place he longed to be. Whereas Deacon Perry Bedger can now say, I have fought the good fight, I have finished the race, I have kept the faith. Now there is in store for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will award to me on that day. And not only to me, but also to all those who have longed for his appearance, 2 Timothy 4, 7 and 8. Whereas Deacon Perry Bedger has reunited with his beloved wife, Sister Norma Bedger, whom he loved and cherished and truly missed. Whereas they showed us by example what a marriage between two godly people should be like. Whereas Deacon Perry Bedger was a very generous giver and worked tirelessly in the church as a teacher, a bus driver, a repairman, a choir member, a treasurer, and whatever was needed to keep God's church going. Whereas he took his calling as deacon very seriously and was a member of the local deacon board. Whereas we will remember Deacon Perry Bedger as a man who loved God and loved God's people. Whereas everyone who knew him has a Brother Bedinger story to tell, whether they knew him for 40 years or 5 minutes. Whereas some will say he delivered me vegetables from his garden, or he helped me out financially, or he shared his godly wisdom. And yes, sometimes he used that Army Sergeant experience on me to correct me. Whereas God rewarded Deacon Perry Bedinger with 101 years on this earth, because of the life that he lived and has now called home, he called him home to give him rest and say, well done, my good and faithful servant. You have been faithful with a few things. I'll put you in charge of many things. Come and share your master's happiness. Matthew 25, 21. Therefore, we have come to the end of a journey, but yet it is a good day. An earthly journey has ended, a heavenly residence has begun, and we look forward to seeing our dear brother again in his new heavenly home. We will always love and remember Deacon Perry Bedger and all the things he taught us by example. He will always be a part of the Cane Run Missionary Baptist Church, and for many of us, he is part of who we are today. To the family of Deacon Perry Bedger, we know your sorrow is great, but we want you to know that we share in your sorrow. But more importantly, we recognize that his loss is heaven's gain. We would like you to remember, in case there's a time when you just need some cheer, in case there's a problem you would like us to hear, in case there's a favor you would like us to do, we're here if you need us to help see you through. Humbly submitted on this 18th day of April, 2020, by the Cane Run Missionary Baptist Church, Jordan L. Thompson, pastor. Amen. 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 And do we have any other acknowledgments? Amen. We'll now have obituary read, Sally. After obituary being read, Sally, we'll have any remarks. And walk around heaven.
Amen.
And then we'll have remarks. And then we'll have another solo by Janika Williams, I Shall Wear a Crown, and then we'll come back with the words of comfort for today. One of these mornings won't be very long.
Yeah.
You'll look for me and I'll be gone. I'm going to a place.
Yeah.
Where I have nothing to do.
Come on, say it.
I'll just walk around heaven all day. When I get to heaven, gonna sing and shout.
Yeah.
Nobody will be able to put me out.
Come on.
My mother, she'll be waiting.
Yeah.
And my father too. Just
walk around
heaven all day. Lord up above, can't you hear me praying? Walk right by my
thank you.
Christmas, the homegoing celebration. But that word celebrate means you gotta have some joy, because Grandpa Bettinger, Deacon Bettinger, Daddy Bettinger would have joy. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. He wouldn't want us to be sad and sitting around, just sitting here knowing that the Lord was being praised and that his legacy was being celebrated. This is a homegoing, that's good news, church. This is a homegoing celebration, amen, because he knew the Lord. Amen. And everybody don't have a homegoing celebration, amen, because they ain't going to the home we going. Amen. But we all that know the Lord, we got a home to go to, and he promised and has prepared a place for us.
Yes,
amen. So, amen. One glad morning when this life is over. Amen. We all got to leave this place. Amen.
Amen.
We're just soldiers traveling through. Amen.
Amen.
And Deacon Bettinger was a soldier. Amen. So he was a soldier in United States Army, but he was also a soldier in the army of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So I need us to get our praises up, because somebody said when praises go up,
blessings
come down.
Yes,
amen.
Sir.
Amen. And anything dead ought to be buried. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We'll now have any remarks. If there are any other remarks from any family member that wants to come up, feel free at this time to come up and give remarks. If anybody wants to give remarks, and we want to just try to remember to limit those to just a few moments. But if you have any remarks, now's that time for you to come with your remarks. Amen. Amen. There are no remarks. So well, now I have a solo. Our first soloist was from one of our members from Canyon Run Missionary Baptist Church, where I have service pastor, Sonoma Jean Jackson. Now we'll have another one of our members, Sister Janiqua Williams, with I Sure Will Wear a Crown.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Amen. And Father Janiqua will have a word from the Lord.
I shall wear a crown.
Yeah, 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 come on.
I shall wear a crown.
Tell the story how I made.
hand clap of praise. Amen. 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 This is, again, a great occasion. And we all must go this way. Amen.
Amen.
We all have a birth date and we all have a death date. Amen. But the most important thing is that we know the Lord. Again, let's go to God in prayer. Father God, we thank you for this word. God, let these words be your words and be your thoughts. Let these words be comfort to this family, God. God, we thank you, God, once again for the life and legacy of Perry Bettinger. 101 years, God, a man who saw so many things. God, we just thank you, God, for all the wisdom, all the knowledge that he's partaken and given to us. God, we thank you for the love that he shared not only with this family, God, but many all across this city and state of Kentucky. God, we thank you for those members of the Meadowlawn Church that he loved so dearly, and for the members of the Cane Run Missionary Baptist Church, God, that he loved so dearly as well. God, thank you for a man of God, a tireless worker, a servant. God, we thank you for him, and God, we know just by him living the way you would want him to live, that he preached his own eulogy. But now, God, give us strength to preach this your word, God. God, we just thank you once again for this day of celebration. For this day, God, where we send your soldier home to you, God, to study war no more. It's in the mighty, master's miraculous name of Jesus we pray. Amen and amen.
Amen.
Amen. Coming from the book of Psalms today, Psalm 27. And I'll be reading from King James Version, Psalm 27. And I'll be reading the first 5 verses. The word of the Lord reads, says, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even my enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and fell. The whole should encamp against me. My heart shall not fear. The war should rise against me. In this will I be confident. One thing I have desired of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For in the time of trouble, he shall hide me in his pavilion. In the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me upon a rock. Amen. Just for the time that we have with you today, I just want to tag this text, the testimony of a good man. Mm-hmm. Amen. I didn't hear nobody say that, but the testimony of a good man.
Amen.
Today we are not here by happenstance, but we're here by divine orchestration of the Lord. We are here to celebrate the homegoing of Perry Bettinger because Perry Bettinger knew the Lord. And what I've discovered in life is It's one thing to hear about God. It's one thing to read about God. But it's another thing to reach a place of knowing God and knowing God for yourself. Bettinger knew who he was and whose he was. And because he knew who he was and whose he was able to discover who he was as a man. And after discovering who he was as a man, he was then able to put his trust in whose he was. Because whose he was created him and knew everything about him. And if God created him, he knew every move and every step that Perry Bettinger would make and every step that he took. That's why the Bible says that the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. And because Perry Bettinger was a good man, God orchestrated his steps from the beginning of time. I wish I had somebody to help me up in here.
All right.
And even though his steps were ordered and the Lord was on his side, he knew who the Lord was for himself. And even though he knew who the Lord was, church, there were still some days that he would have trouble. Because family, if you live in this world, you will have some trouble.
Amen.
If you live in this world, family, you will have some ups and downs.
Mm-hmm.
If you live in this world, you'll have good days and bad days. Does anybody know what I'm talking about?
Yes.
We've all had our good days and bad days, but with God on our side, he can turn a bad day into a good day. And here recently, he had some health and physical and nutritional trouble. He had gotten to a place that he didn't want to take his medicine no more. He didn't want nothing to eat no more. And we as a family knew that he had already had health troubles before in the past because he had a pacemaker. But God brought him through that. And God kept him through all those years of dealing with heart trouble and heartache and heartbreak. But we know that God doesn't make any mistakes. I wish I had somebody to say something. I said, we know God doesn't make any mistakes. But we all face different things and troubles in our lives. Because our friend Job reminds us that man that is born of a woman is of a few days and full of trouble. And here in our text today, we find David, a man, I believe that David and Perry Bettinger had some similarities. And I believe they both had testimonies.
Yeah.
David, the soldier who was in King Saul's army. David, the husband. David, the father. David, the giant slayer. David, the sheep herder on his daddy's farm and on his daddy's land. David, the man after God's own heart.
Yes,
but don't you see the resemblance between David and Bettinger? David was a master soldier, and David was high in command, but Bettinger was a soldier, a master sergeant, and high in command.
Mm-hmm.
David fought in some battles, and David fought in some wars. But Bettinger fought in some battles, and Bettinger fought in some wars. David worked and tended sheep on his daddy Jesse's farmland. But Perry also tended vegetables on his farmland. I wish I had somebody help me. And he would bring those vegetables to every and anybody. David had to keep wolves from getting to his sheep. But Bettinger had to keep the birds and squirrels and other animals from eating his crops. Don't you see the similarities?
Yes, sir.
Oh, David was a giant slayer, but so was Bettinger. Because Bettinger kept slaying the giant called heart trouble. Bettinger kept slaying the giant called sickness. And he fought a good fight for 101 years. He kept the faith, and he finished his course.
Yes.
David was a man after God's own heart. Well, Bettinger was a man after God's own heart.
Yes.
Don't you see the similarities, church? Don't you see the similarities, family? But in the end, Bettinger needed strength because he just didn't have the strength that he had anymore. But Gene, he taught me a long time ago, even before I became a preacher, that when you need strength, you got to go to the Lord for your strength.
Amen.
When you need strength, you got to go to the Word for your strength. And I listened to him, as most of us have, because he was a man of wisdom. And when I need strength, church, and when I need encouragement to make it through another week, I go to the book of Psalms. For every shifting mood that I have, for every emotional trauma I go through, for every difficult issue in life, we can find an answer, an antidote in the book of Psalms. Stick with me because I'm going somewhere. There are imprecatory psalms where David asks God to kill his enemies. And then there are psalms of praise and psalms of lament. But each of those psalms contains a word for you and for me. A psalm for us and a word for when our souls need to be encouraged. And can I just have a few minutes to walk through a few of the psalms? Like, blessed is the man that walketh not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor standeth in the way of sinners, nor sitteth in the seat of the scornful. For his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in that law does he meditate day and night. And he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water, that bringeth forth fruit in its season, and its leaf shall not wither, and whatsoever he doeth shall prosper. Or how about, O Lord, our Lord, how excellent is thy name in all the earth. How about, lift up your heads, O you gates, and be ye lifted up, you everlasting doors, and the King of glory shall come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. Or how about this one? Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, and his mercy endureth forever. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. How about this one? Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know you that the Lord, he is God, and is he who has made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people. I don't hear y'all saying that. The sheep of his pasture. Enter, it says, enter into his gates with thanksgiving, and his courts with praise. Be faithful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his truth endure to all generations. How about I'll bless the Lord at all times? His praises shall continually be in my mouth. What about let everything that has breath? Can y'all ain't get me? Let everything that has breath,
yes,
praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. What about the Lord is my shepherd, and I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness for his name. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I'll fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I'll dwell in the house of the Lord forever. But one of my favorites by far, church, one of my favorites by far, family, is Psalm 27. Therefore, David testifies and gives testimony that the Lord is my light and my salvation.
Amen.
He says, whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid?
Yes.
Psalm 27 is David's testimony, and I believe it was Perry Bettinger's testimony as well. It offers to the believer, first and foremost, personal guidance. Somebody say it's personal.
It's personal.
David writes this psalm from a place of personal experience, mama, from his life and his own troubles. And amen, this is why the white writer declared the Lord is. Because who the Lord is whatever you need him to be. Yes. Y'all ain't said, yes. I said, who the Lord is whoever and whatever you need him to be. And this is why we've got to put our trust in him and not in man. And I don't know what all you may be going through other than this, and what all you're dealing with or how you feel right now, but we got to learn, family, to put our trust in the Lord. Even when things get a little rough, that's why David was able to declare that the Lord is. Somebody say the Lord is.
The Lord is.
Yeah, because you can pause right there, because who he is whatever you need him to be. Well, who is he? He's Jehovah Jireh, the Lord our provider. Who is he? He's a very present help in the time of trouble. Who is he? He's my refuge and strength. He's my joy in sorrow. He's my hope for tomorrow. So that's why you and I can declare that the Lord is. David says, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? Because he is that, David makes it personal. Just like he did in Psalm 23, he made it personal. But back to Psalm 27, he says, the Lord is the strength of my life. And because of that, David didn't have to be scared of nobody. He says, of whom shall I be afraid? It's right there in the text. And I believe that Grandpa Besner wasn't afraid of anything that I know of. Not even death, because he was saved. And he's been ready to go on to the other side since Grandma went on to glory. David says that when the wicked, my enemies, and my foes came to eat my flesh, those folks that didn't mean him no good, the ones that came to do him in, that looked in his face and stabbed in the back, before they can get to you, before our enemies can get to us, God causes them to stumble and fall. And I want to share with you before I come to a close, not only was it Bedinger's testimony that he had personal guidance, but I believe he could and would testify that he had powerful guardianship. Somebody say powerful guardianship. Oh, it's there in the text, because in the time of trouble, he will hide me in his pavilion. David makes it clear, Nisi, that the pavilion is in the center of the camp. And Carlita, while the tents of his army are all around, he's in the pavilion. In essence, before you can get to the king, you got to come through the troops. Oh, I wish I had somebody to say something. Before you could get to the king, you had to go through the troops. That sounds like what a master sergeant might be doing against a battle attack against them is in the pavilion. Somebody shout, God was in the pavilion. Perry Bedinger is in the pavilion. And then I believe David and Bedinger shares and testifies that not only do they have a personal guidance, not only do they have powerful guardianship, but Keith and Junior, but lastly, I believe David and Bedinger had profound glory.
Yes.
Somebody shout profound glory.
Profound.
Because I hear him saying that he shall hide me in his pavilion. He shall place me upon a rock.
Yes.
Tell somebody he's going to hide you in plain sight. Yeah, because God is the only person that can hide you on a rock. In other words, God said that I will hide you where people can see you, but they can't get to you. Preach, Jordan Thompson, I'm doing the best I can. Because I came to tell somebody that your life and your legacy ought to be a testimony service.
Amen.
That you've lived your life to where not only you have a testimony about your life, and you live your life where you preach your own eulogy, like Perry Bedinger did, but that everybody else around you that you came in contact with will have a testimony or a good story about your life and about you, because you were a good man or a good woman. And since Perry Bedinger is not down here no more, I believe he would want me to let you know one of the scriptures that he quoted to me all the time when we would talk one of the scriptures that he would always say was for him to live is Christ, but to die is gain. Not when he would say that if this earthly house, this tabernacle be dissolved, I've got another building not made by man's hands. What are you saying, Pastor? I'm saying that his testimony, that he had hope beyond the grave. Yeah. And I just need to know, do I have some folk up in here that got hope beyond the grave?
Yeah.
That know that you're going to see Grandpa Bettinger again.
Yeah.
That you're going to see Grandma Bettinger again. That if you live right, when we all get to heaven,
what a day,
what a day of rejoicing it will be. What a family union we'll have when we see Jesus. We can sing and shout the victory. Well, just a few weeks ago at the St. Mary and Elizabeth Hospital, I prayed a prayer and I said, God, I need you to heal Grandpa Bettinger. I said, God, I need you to heal Deacon Bettinger. God, I need you to heal Master Sergeant Bettinger. We need him back with the family. We need him back at the church. We need him back for the kingdom of God. And I could hear God saying, all I need you to do, Thompson, is to have faith in God that everything I do, Thompson, is going to work out all right. You see, all of us want a God that prevents stuff from happening. We want a God that will stop stuff from happening. But I want a God that even if it happens, he's still able to fix it. I said, I want a God that even if it happens, he's still able to take care of us. Does anybody know he's still able to take care of you? Tell somebody, say he's able. See, I know you've been crying, but he's able. I know you've been upset, but he's able. I know you've been sad, but he's able. I know you don't know what you're going to do without Grandpa and without Daddy, but guess what? He's able.
Yeah.
I know you've been walking floors, but here's the confidence, even now, that God is still able. Somebody shout one more time, he's still able.
Yeah.
Because if God wanted to, he could have stopped this, but it takes faith to believe that God, if he wanted to, he could reverse this situation. He could have, but God said, I'm going to heal him, but I'm going to heal him in my own way. I said, God said he was going to heal him, but he was going to heal him in his own way. Because he's got a 101-year-old body, but I'm going to heal him, Thompson, in my own way. And aren't you glad, family, that I ain't God? Because I would have kept Grandpa here. I would have kept him here suffering through trial and tribulation. I would have kept him here just so I could see his face. But God, he's the kind of God that says, I know better than you. And if I have some witnesses up in here that you ever had some heartaches, that's ever had some heartbreaks, ever had some struggles, and ever had some situation, look at somebody and say, God knows best. Yeah, I say God is able. I said, look around and tell somebody, God knows better than we do. Say God knows best. See, I was reading the article as I get ready to close. I was reading an article the other day, and it brought to my remembrance about a race car driver. This race car driver was driving in the Indianapolis 500, and he had wrecked the car, Keith, and he called the owner, and he told the owner, he said, owner, I tore the car up. And the owner said, Nisi, what do you mean you tore it up? Well, Janice, he said, I tore the car up. The owner said, is there any part of the car that's still good? The owner said, look at the bumper and the fender and see if it's still good. The driver looked at the bumper and he looked at the fender. He said, they ain't no good. The owner said, look at the hood, see if that's any good. And the driver said, no, the hood ain't no good. The owner said, look at the tires. And the driver said, no, boss, The tires ain't no good. The owner said, you mean to tell me that there's nothing good about the car? Then the driver lifted up the hood of a Ram and he looked under the hood and he said, the boss, he said, the car is destroyed, but the motor's still good. I hope y'all know where I'm going. He said, owner, I said, the car is destroyed, but the engine's still good. I'm finished now, but I claim to declare that on Wednesday evening, April 8th, around 4:10 p.m., I can imagine I heard Grandpa say, boss, the bumper and fender is messed up. Boss, the hood is messed up too. Boss, the tires are flat and messed up. And I heard Jesus say, Perry, is there anything good in it? And he lifted up the hood. Grandpa lifted up the hood. Deacon Benjamin lifted up the hood. And he said, Lord, everything else is messed up, but the motor's still good. And I heard the boss say, leave the body, but bring the engine on home. I said, I heard the boss say, leave the body, but bring the motor on home. Because to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. Benja got a brand new body, because if this earthly tabernacle be destroyed, we've got a brand new home, not made by man's hand. No more trouble, no more sickness, no more pain, no more hurt. He's reunited with his sweetheart again. So I redid the song by Peaches and Herb. It said reunited and it feels so good. Reunited and it's understood. There's one perfect fit and sugar, that one was it. Y'all both are so excited, Grandma and Grandpa, cause you're reunited. Hey, hey, can somebody say hey, hey?
Hey, hey.
Can somebody say hey, hey?
Hey, hey.
Grandma and Grandpa, you beat me there, but I'm on my way. Is there anybody here that knows God is able? You ought to say yes. If you know God is able, say yes. Won't he do it? Sleep on, Grandpa. Take your rest. Somebody besides me ought to be able to testify that if it had not been for the Lord on your side, where would you be? Somebody besides me ought to be able to testify. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Through many dangers, toils and snares, I've already come. Tell your neighbor, I've got a testimony.
Yeah.
Tell your neighbor, I've got a testimony. Say it goes something like this. God is my refuge and my strength, a very present help in the time of trouble. Tell somebody else, I've got a testimony. Blessed assurance, blessed assurance, blessed assurance. Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchased by God, born of his spirit, washed in his blood. This is my testimony. This is my song. Praising. Will you praise him? Praise him, my Savior. All the day long. Benji had a testimony. And he lived his testimony. You and I've got a testimony. We've got a story to tell of how we made it over. How we made it through. Because soon and very soon, we're all going to see the King. Going up to yonder to be with my Lord. Amen. God bless you, family. God bless you. Amen. Well, we'll now do the committal here in this sanctuary. We'll do the committal. We know that we will bury him on Monday at Kentucky Ferry, but we'll now do the committal. The Lord knows all and sees all. The Lord knows about this our dear departed brother. We now commit his body to the ground. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. We thank God for receiving him into his kingdom. Amen. Let us pray. Our Father God, we ask you to just continue to be with this family. God, you know the hurt, you know the pain, you know the sadness. Thank God that he left his old body here, but he took the engine, took the motor on up to heaven, where he's got a new body, where he's rejoicing and reunited with his sweetheart. We thank you, Lord, that you are a keeper. We thank you that you're a sustainer. We thank you, God, that we can hold on to your unchanging hands. Now, God, continue to go with us. Continue to stand by us. Now, may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, and sweet communion of the Holy Spirit, may rest, may rule, may abide henceforth, now, and forevermore. And all God's children said, amen.
Amen.
I don't think that was never recording.
It was, one was. I know one of them was.